Fear, anxiety, the progress killers. The biggest reasons why people give up or why they don't even try at all. How's it going, everyone? I'm the Tumblemeister, and in today's video, we're exploring how to overcome fear and anxiety in tumbling, and we're starting now. As a tumbler and as a tumbling coach, I deal with fear every single day. My biggest goal is to build tumblers strong enough so that they can overcome fear and anxiety, not just in their tumbling, but in their lives as well. Through my experience, I have learned three main concepts that have helped me and my tumblers overcome fear and anxiety. Let's start with number one, controlling what you can control. The first part of controlling what you can control is availability. In order to build our strength and our trust in ourselves, we have to show up every day. You can't train like a part-time athlete trying to do full-time athlete things. Showing up on good days and bad days is key to building the trust in yourself and your abilities. Taking a tumbling break in the middle of learning a skill can stunt the growth of that skill in the future when the tumbler returns. If you didn't have it solid when you left, you can't expect to feel like you have it solid when you return. Making practices and training a vital part of your schedule is the first step to controlling what you can control. Taking your preparation seriously can keep fear out of your plans. How you eat, how you sleep, the music you listen to, all help in the preparation process for you as a tumbler. Walking into the gym without stretching and going straight to your hardest skills is a recipe for having a bad day. On the contrary, warming up 50 times before you get to your hardest skills isn't gonna help you progress either. Knowing what to prepare for and how to prepare for it can help you focus on the task at hand and keep unneeded thoughts out of your head. Your preparation and your warm-up are what you go back to when the harder things aren't working. With my tumblers, we call it building your floor. Building your floor is when you make a skill so easy, so natural, that if you ever got to the point where you couldn't do that skill, it would only happen if you'd stopped tumbling or if you retired. Skills that become part of your floor are like walking or like doing a handstand or a cartwheel. You do them without thinking. If I say do a cartwheel, you do a cartwheel without thinking. If I say do a full, you might think about it a little bit. Taking pride in your preparation can help you make the hard things easy and the easy things easier. Once you make it easy, there's no reason to fear it. The third thing you can control is your effort. You're gonna find some resistance if you're trying to complete a task at 100% with 70% effort. If you're not trying your hardest, you deserve to be afraid of something. If it's easy, that doesn't mean you can't get hurt or you can't mess it up. And if it's hard, the first thing the difficulty is measuring is your effort. You had to do one of anything with your life on the line. How much effort would you put into that one? In tumbling, anything can get us hurt. And if you're not taking every aspect seriously, something's gonna scare you or get you hurt. Injuries may be the biggest reason why people fear tumbling and doing harder skills. While you can't control injuries, you can control your preparation, which gets you ready for the skill, and you can control your effort when you're actually doing the skill. If you don't value each part of the round off, the back handspring, and the rebound when you're warming up, then one of those parts could actually mess you up when you're going for your tuck, your layout, your full, or your double. If you warmed up a bad rebound on your 2 to rebound, then when you go for your 2 to tuck and you don't rebound, you can't say you don't know why that didn't happen. If you're having a bad warm up and you know you're giving your 100% effort, you can say, hey, today's a day that I'm gonna be working on cleaning skills instead of working on harder skills. Vice versa, if you know you're having one of those great days where you're barely even trying and your harder skills feel easy, those are the days where you wanna try to do even harder stuff and you wanna try to progress maybe a little bit more, or maybe try to work on things that you couldn't work on when you were having a bad day or having a regular day. A tumbler's biggest fear is being out of control. The more we can control, the more power we have. Now, the second most important concept is asking the right question. The best questions are the ones that are trying to solve problems, not create them. As a problem solver, you want to try to find the I don't knows. I don't knows lead to hesitation, and hesitation lead right to the path of fear. I sound like a Jedi master right now. One of the biggest signs of giving up I see is when a person goes straight to an I don't know. If you're not trying to solve the problem isn't going to try to solve itself. When we're afraid or feeling anxious about tumbling, we like to blame the fear itself instead of something specific like I'm not having enough power or my feet are in the wrong spot when I punch. When we don't know something that we should know, it leads to intense frustration. The second part to asking the right questions is no negativity. How are you going to find a positive solution with a negative mindset? That was a good question. The biggest reason why we all are tumblers, why we're doing all these skills that can get us hurt and that are super dangerous, is that we love it. We don't want what we love to be surrounded with negative thoughts and ideas. Instead of asking, am I good enough? Instead ask, am I strong enough? Instead of asking, will people laugh at me if I fall? Instead ask, what's the worst that could happen if I try my hardest? A tumbler has to be their own biggest supporter. Everything we do comes down to our own responsibility. Believing in yourself to do scary things starts with asking the right positive questions. Finally, to ask the right questions, you need honesty. If you're constantly lying to yourself, eventually you're not going to be able to live up to that lie. Your tumbling is a part of you, like your smile, like your wink, like your laugh. Could you imagine trying to fake your laugh or your smile or your wink every single day? It wouldn't be natural, so it'd be different because you wouldn't remember what the last one you did was. That's kind of like in tumbling. If you don't do what's natural, then it's going to be different, and then you won't be able to control if it's different every time. Not knowing what's going to happen is going to be one of the biggest causes to you being afraid of it. Being honest about your work ethic, about your own bravery, about your trust in yourself, your skill, and your tumbling. If you're a person that doesn't take responsibility and you blame everything that happens to you on some outside factor that's outside your control, then maybe seeing the truth in that could be the biggest thing to help you. Part of taking responsibility is being honest with ourselves. Improvement starts with honesty. Most of the time, the truth is already scary as it is. The third vital concept in overcoming fear and anxiety in your tumbling is working with people you trust. That fear, that stress, that anxiety, all that leads us to not trust ourselves. And when we don't trust ourselves, the most important thing to have is somebody that we do trust. Whether it be another tumbler, whether it be a teammate, whether it be your head coach, maybe it's your tumbling coach. You need somebody that can tell you how it is and can give you corrections that you believe are actually going to help you. You need to surround yourself with people that have more experience, more knowledge, and that have a different perspective. The answer to your problems might lie in the total opposite way of how you're thinking. Working with people that have seen it before or have done it before can help you build trust not only in yourself, but in you doing the skill. If a coach knows that a feeling that you have is a natural part of you learning a certain skill, then it's gonna help take off some of the stress when you can say, hey, everybody feels like this when they're learning this skill. The bond between a tumbling coach and their tumblers is something extraordinary. Every day we are working with something that is very dangerous and that can cause harm not only to your body, but to your mind as well. Anxious tumblers usually are anxious people in their normal lives. Working with coaches that understand your limitations and that understand different ways to help you progress can help keep fear and anxiety to a minimum when learning. You can know how to do everything and you can be able to do everything, but if you don't trust it all coming together, what's going to take the place of that trust is fear. Fear can be a good thing. Fear can be used as a form of respect. We always want to have respect for every skill that we do as tumblers. Whether it be a forward roll or a double full, each skill is hard in its own way and is dangerous in their own way. Learning how to overcome your fears, not just in tumbling, but in life, can help build you and help you achieve all of your goals. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hoped I helped you even just a little bit. If you learned something and you liked the video, please like and leave a comment on what is your biggest fear or what skill are you afraid of the most. Check out some of my other videos too. Please subscribe for more tumbling wisdom, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.